And it's really important that men should not worry about their T levels when they're masturbating.
That's the last thing I'm worried about when I'm masturbating. Hey everybody, I'm JC Mendoza, and welcome to Uncomfortable Questions, where I get to ask a doctor about everything we're all dying to know but are too embarrassed to ask about. With me today is Dr. Peter Stahl. He is a board-certified urologist and a national leader on male sexual medicine. How are you doing today, Dr. Peter?
I'm awesome. It's great to be here with you.
You know, on the internet, people say a lot of stuff.
They
say a lot of things. It's hard to know what's real, what's fake. They say the moon landing was fake. They say Bigfoot is real. They say pineapples don't belong on pizza. And they say masturbation decreases testosterone count. Ron, is there any truth to that?
There is, in like a tiny way, that is probably not clinically important or important in life, and I'll go through that. But the big answer, the take home, is that masturbation is healthy. It does not have a negative long-term impact on testosterone, testosterone levels, or any of the important things that testosterone does in the human body.
So Dr. Pete, what are the actual facts about how masturbation affects testosterone?
Okay, two conflicting studies to talk about. Both a small set of young men that were brought into a lab, masturbated and ejaculated in the lab, and then had blood tests before, during, and after masturbation at regular intervals.
That's an intense day.
It's a pretty intense study. And there are two of them, and they've had conflicting results. One of them showed really no differences or changes in hormone levels at the time of orgasm or in the immediate period afterwards.
Okay.
That study, though, did have one interesting finding, and that was that if men abstained from ejaculating for 3 weeks leading into the study,
right,
that resulted in statistically higher testosterone levels at the start than men who did not have a period of ejaculatory abstinence.
Okay, and some people would call that proof.
Yes, statistically significant, but really important to note, very small actual difference, 20 nanograms per deciliter, nothing that's gonna have a big impact on desire, orgasm, ejaculation, muscle building.
Right.
Another study though, same setup basically, there was no ejaculatory abstinence.
Right.
But in this study, the men that ejaculated were protected against the slow decline in testosterone levels that tends to occur over the course of a normal day.
Oh, so the opposite of proof.
Right, so we have a small positive effect, a small negative effect. In the end, I don't think there's really a major clinically important effect, and it's really important that men should not worry about their T levels when they're masturbating.
That's good to know, but then why do you think these conspiracy guys are so worried about testosterone in the first place?
Well, you know, testosterone is identified with kind of masculinity. It is a really important hormone. People think of it as a sex hormone, they think of it as like a muscle building hormone, and those are both true, right? Testosterone is important for erections, for sexual desire, for building muscle, for losing fat, but there's also lots of other effects of testosterone in the body on things like cognition, mood, energy, sleep. So it is a really important hormone, and we know that as men get older, testosterone levels decline over time. So the likelihood of having hypogonadism, which is actually the term.
Hypogonadism?
Hypo, like hypo. Too low. Gonad, like balls.
That's a real term.
Gonadism.
I thought gonads was slang.
Hypogonadism is actually the clinical syndrome of having measured low testosterone levels and symptoms that actually make sense for low T. It's not enough to just be like tired and have a low sex drive or to just have low testosterone levels and feel good.
Okay.
You gotta have both to really be diagnosed. And once you're diagnosed, that's when you start talking with a healthcare provider like me about, you know, how can you raise your T levels and what are the risks and benefits of doing that.
So would you say that low testosterone is a serious diagnosis?
I'd say that low testosterone is an important medical diagnosis that has real health implications. It's not serious like a heart attack is serious.
Right.
But low T has been associated with all kinds of adverse long-term health outcomes, including actually cardiovascular disease. But you gotta be careful about diagnosis because a lot of people are overdiagnosed, and you have to be very careful about treatment if you decide to pursue some kind of treatment.
Our guide in the link below right here, it's gonna go more into detail about low testosterone and how to notice the signs that you may be at risk and if you need to talk to your healthcare provider. What in your expert opinion would be a normal testosterone level?
Yeah, usually that's a really easy question to answer for most lab tests. For testosterone, it really isn't.
No.
Because unlike most lab tests that have like a very precise value that is normal, there's a huge and very wide range of normal in testosterone. It also varies lab to lab. So each lab has its own individual normal values, but a typical range might be something like 270 nanograms per deciliter all the way up to 800 or 900.
That's a big range.
So it's a huge range, right? And I think what that speaks to is that some people probably need more testosterone than other people. Mm. There's probably intra-individual and inter-individual variation in how much T you need. And so it's even more of a reason to, you know, interpret everything alongside a partnered healthcare provider that can help you sort through your results and figure out if treatment is right for you.
Now, the last thing I do want to clear up with you is I have heard that when you masturbate, all of your past relatives are watching you. And your level of expertise, is that true?
God, I hope not, JC. I really hope not.
Me too, doctor. That's what I like to hear. That's all for us today, man.
All right, man.
Appreciate y'all. And if you guys want to hear more uncomfortable questions, please like and subscribe for more content.